Could I provide, please? Could I introduce case number CPC 2012-3028-CUZV with the associated CEQA? A request to item 7 first, which is a continuance, which I think is very good. So we're going to go to item 7. Can I introduce case number CPC 2011-3128-GPAZC-HD associated with CEQA, Council District Number 14, General Plan and Uses Low Residential. Public hearing was held on 7-12, and the expiration date is August 17.
Good morning, Commissioners. Good morning. This is the City Planning Department. It's such a pleasure to be here this morning. You should have received a letter that was issued by the applicant's representative, King Bartolo, dated August 6, 2013. This is a letter asking for a continuance on this item. Basically, highlight the reason. It indicates that the purpose of the continuance request is to allow the applicant to step back and both rethink the project and perform additional community outreach. I am not sure if the applicant or the representative is here today, but I know a member of the council office, Councilman Louisa's office, is here today if you'd like to speak to them on the matter.
We've also got 16 people here to speak against the project who have spent the morning with us. Commissioners, we need to say how we want to handle this. I hate to ask everybody to come back yet again on this project. We could take the time to hear it, but I think your testimony might be more valuable in the future. I'd like to make a brief comment. I think this project is really struggling, and I'm glad to see it's not continuing today. There's many things that I think are disturbing about the project, and so having it being rethought is a very good thing. So I want to thank you all for being here, but I think your testimony would be better spent looking at a new project, and hopefully this next project will be much more considerate about the access, pedestrian access, and the, let's call it, the density on the hill. So with that, I apologize to everyone who's been here and waited, but I really don't think we'll have the value in going through that process today. I'm willing to make the motion that we continue this case.
Yield it.
Do we want to have any discussion about this?
Yes.
Commissioner Perlman, I will second that. I would just like to ask the members of the public. We very much value and want to have your insight. The problem is, if you speak today, we don't have what would be the final project in front of us. Your comments won't really be applicable to what, I mean, may never come back to this bill, and we won't have it in mind at the time we're actually dealing with the project.
So let's try this. How many people would like to speak today on this case? How many do we have? Would it be of help to the applicant to hear what they have to say?
Is the applicant here?
Yes.
If I give you a very short amount of time, can you still make make your points? I know it's hard to do, but at least this way, you know, you haven't spent the morning here for no reason.
Pardon me, Commissioner Rochelle, if I may just let you know how the code works.
Please.
This includes an application for a general plan amendment. I'm sorry, not an application for a general plan amendment, but an initiation. An applicant can apply for a general plan amendment, only the Planning Commission, the Director, or the Council can initiate. This body has 90 days to act upon a plan amendment once the Director's report is submitted to it. So that would be the outside limit for you to rehear the case, or else it would be a recommendation moving to the council, just so you're aware of that.
So if we continue it, if it doesn't come back within 90 days?
90 days, I think, is from the date the report, the recommendation report is sent.
Lisa, how do we handle that?
The commission could take testimony today, limited testimony, and then continue the matter to a time no greater than 3 months out, at which time I would expect that the commission would be entertaining a modified project that may in fact require some modifications to the entitlement request being made.
And if the if we don't get the applicant coming back within that time, how do we respond?
The staff will bring before to you a recommendation to deny the general plan amendment.
Before the expiration date?
Correct.
All right, so if commissioners, I know Dana, you feel differently, let's talk quickly. I'd say that because everybody's been here this long, let's get the best advice from the community relative to this project with the applicant, be able to hear it. I'll put a minute on the clock for each speaker. Is that
I have my only comments to the members of the public that come to speak. If you can speak, then not towards the specific details of the project you've seen, because that may involve, but perhaps more traffic impact and neighborhood impact and so on. That would be helpful.
That sounds great. So let's go ahead and get into it, James, and then on the clock for each speaker. I'll ask you to come up and queue behind the speaker stand in groups of four. I think because we're looking at a continuance, I just want to do the public hearing, but I'll ask the applicant if they want to speak.
If you want to speak, I guess.
You would like to speak? Let's go ahead and start with the applicant. No, let's start with the applicant first. And I'm going to ask you to restrict your time to a minute so we can move through this.
Good morning, commissioners. My name is Alvaro Bonegas. I am the applicant, and I was not prepared to speak this morning. My representative called me at 6:30 this morning saying I need to represent myself because she felt ill last night. So that being said, this project has a lot of controversy right now. I have been working with the advisory board of the area for the past 6 years on this project. Documentation, we have that. We've been back and forth on 13 meetings. It's now recently have a lot of opposition on this project. We're wanting and going to work with the community to revise our project and maybe at the same time just redo a whole new different type of project on the site. So I think in all fairness, we've gone through all the channels and everything properly that we get that opportunity to revise our project and go back to the community and sit with them on one-on-one and work this out.
Thank you for your willingness to work with the department. We appreciate it.
Thank you, and congratulations on your 8 years of service to the city of LA.
Could I invite up Dr. Tom Williams, Claudia V. Munoz, Laura Lopez, and Mary Lopez?
Well, Dr. Tom Williams, LA 32 Neighborhood Council, retired. Basic issue, the general plan amendment. In the supporting documents, it says that it's going to form a transition between the intense commercial development to the north and the persistent residential single-family dwellings to the south. However, there are only 5 commercial properties from Lombardy to Gambier out of 30 on one side of the street, because the other side of the street is a school. So it forms no transition. The transition is already there. North of Gambier, there is commercial. South of Gambier, there's 5 out of 30 only along one side of the street. So the basic element is no commercial development on this parcel. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome.
Claudia Magaña Munoz, resident of the Hillside Village area. My concern is the rezoning request for the project. I'm concerned with the impact of rezoning on the hillsides for an area that's known for its hillsides and for the wildlife and the use of its hillsides in their natural state. The request would produce a great impact on safety, on the environment itself, and create a different sense of community, and not to mention a completely different look. you to oppose the project. Thank you.
Anya, thank you. Welcome. And before you begin, can I again invite up the next four? Please just come up and see behind our speaker. Angel Melendez, Chuck Vaughn, Gillian, Gillian Rob-Russo, and Heber, I think it's Martinez. Welcome. Please introduce yourself.
Good morning, my name is Mary Hopkins. I live at 5145 Dartmouth. I'm a longtime resident. I'm opposed to the project of, I'm not opposed to education, because some of us here remember the walkouts of the East Side and some of us were involved. So we're all for education, but it's redundant to have an elementary school built across the street from another elementary school. And then there's a middle school across the street that also has a dental clinic, which generates a lot of traffic coming in and out between Farmdale and Alameda and El Sereno Middle School. We also have seven other elementary schools in the area, two Catholic schools and two charter schools. We have a lot of empty commercial properties, one being at 4882 Huntington Drive that's vacant. We have commercial at 4227 Huntington Drive, which is brand new, it's beautiful, has parking, has never been used. We also have vacant commercial property at 4651 Huntington Drive that has residential above, and we were guaranteed commercial below that's never been used.
Welcome. Please introduce yourself to me again.
My name is Angel Melendez. Good morning, commissioners. The basis, I'm not against development, but to rezone an area, especially with the hillside ordinance that was created in El Sereno, it'd be hypocritical to change that ordinance in our own town to allow commercialization of the hillside. The other point I want to make is, where's the accountability, where's the certification that the neighborhood was notified? Because the biggest concern I see is residents saying they were never notified. I'm at 525 feet outside the circle of notification, but I go down, two doors down my block in the circle, nobody got notification. The developer could say and hire someone that does the outreach, but where's the proof? They could have a reputable company, but where's the proof? Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome.
My name is Chuck Vaughn. I'm a retired teacher, taught at Farmdale Elementary across the street from this project for 32 years. I am a member of the parent teacher organization here. I just wanted a real quick issue with the proposed charter, the proposed rezoning and adding a charter school there. As Mary mentioned earlier, they have many, many, many options in El Sereno area for schooling. This will be devastating to the public schools there in the El Sereno community. If they add a school exactly the same size as Farmway, you know, elementary school. Also, we haven't mentioned it, but I'm sure you'll hear it, the traffic along Eastern Avenue between Huntington Drive and Valley in that morning and afternoon with the schools is horrendous. If you had another signal, and another school across the street, we're asking for a disaster. I strongly encourage you to have these people come back without the idea of a charter school in our county.
Thank you,
Chair.
Thank you. Welcome.
Hello, Jillian
Russom.
I'm a teacher at Roosevelt High School, and as a member of United Teachers Los Angeles, I work with many teachers in the El Sereno community. I wanted to echo concerns if the revised project doesn't include a 500-seat charter school. There are eight local elementary public schools right in the area, two Catholic schools, and Simia's charter school, so there are many choices. And I just think that the commission needs to be aware of the destabilizing impact that it does have on local public schools if a brand new 500-seat school is brought in, destabilizing in terms of very quick loss of enrollment and loss of faculty and staff. And if we aren't drawing enrollment from the local schools, then the enrollment is being drawn in from outside the community, morning traffic and hazards for children in the morning. It also tends to create a two-tier system because it tends to be the families with more resources that seek out that school who are then drawn out of our public schools. So please consider that if a charter school is part of the plan. Thank you.
Thank you for making the time. Before you begin, could I invite up Sergio Bonilla, Melissa Kellogg, Yoli Garcia, and Anna Medina. Welcome.
Good morning. Chair Martinez, President. I think you made clear the main reasons why most of what we're proposing is the value. So I just want to tell you that actually respectfully ask you to consider the findings and recommendations that the planner assigned to this project has made. I truly believe that this project has no benefit to the residents in that area. So I thank you, and I too wish Commission President
thank you. Thank you. Well, please introduce yourself again.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Sergio Benya, and I am strongly against the proposed project for the location on Northeastern Avenue. And I strongly support the city recommended actions. And I'd like to thank you for your time this morning. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good morning, my name is Ana Medina. I live in the Sereno in the north side part, but I own properties on the 2400 Global Eastern Avenue. And my concern is the traffic because to get out of the property is difficult in the morning because there's too much traffic. And I asked tenants if they were notified about this project. And my properties are on the 2400 block, and this is on the 2500 block. And we never received notification until we hear rumors in the neighborhood. So I'm against this project. Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Good morning. I'm a resident of El Sereno, and I am here because I am against the proposed development. I am against any development that requires rezoning or variance to the hillside variance. So I'm asking you in the future, any development that requires rezoning and or a variance to the hillside ordinance, to please deny it. We have the hillside ordinance to protect us from developments such as this. And also in our Northeast LA specific plan, in our community, open space hillside is a characteristic of our community. We would like to keep that open. If you read our Northeast plan, it does specify the hillside for single family residents. We would like to keep it that way. Thank you.
Thank you for being here. If you would mind, before you begin, Patricia Astorja, Tom Takashita, Nancy Delgado, and Teresita De Palma. Well, please introduce yourself.
My name is Melissa Kellogg. I'm a resident of El Sereno. I want to thank you all for hearing our comments this morning. I know you're short on time. And thank you too for your work in shaping our community. Specifically, I do support the staff recommendation. It was a very attentive report. The staff from our department was very willing to hear public comments, and we very much appreciate that. I do want to say that your work in developing all the ordinance that we work under, the general plan, the community plans, has been really thorough. And for a project to come before you that requires so many variances to those plans is disturbing to our community as well. Personally, I would request that you do not grant a continuance, but if the continuance is to be granted for this project, I ask that in your authority, if you urge the property owner to do more than the minimum required to speak this in under the law, but that he actually fully look at the city's present planning goals and pay respect to them for the day.
Thank you for being here. Has everybody who signed the speaker card had a chance to speak? Arturo Rodriguez? Arturo, please come up. Would you come up? Just introduce yourself.
My name is Georgine Acosta. I live on 2830 Chadwick Circle, and I'm really concerned about rezoning the area. You know, as many people have mentioned, it's a hillside area with amazing views, and I'm concerned that if we start putting these kinds of structures in the community, it's going to really change the fabric of our whole neighborhood. I'm also a teacher with UTLA. I oppose the creation of more charter schools, and that's a very complex issue that I don't want to get into, but I just want to put that down for the record. You know, we don't want to see increased traffic in our neighborhood. It's one of the few places in LA where we don't have a traffic problem, and we don't have a big parking problem either. And we don't want that to change. We really like the way our neighborhood is now. 20 trees will be eliminated if that project goes forward, and a big hill will just be gone. And I just support the city's recommendations. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome.
My name is Arturo Rodriguez. I'm a resident of Sereno. First of all, I want to say that when this petition came through, it wasn't properly, you know, dictated to our public. We all live here. It wasn't properly, the public wasn't notified. This project, I'm not saying it's a bad project. I'm just saying it's a bad location for it. You know, the community of Sereno, it's an old residential area. That's what we like about our area. We like that it's a community with open spaces, hilltops, just like our monument. Monument has mountains on it. This open spaces provide a unique view to our residents that live here. They also provide a habitat to our wildlife, that we still have in our community.
Commissioner Perlman,
I echo that, and I hope the applicant, I know the representative is not here today, I'm sorry that she's ill, but I hope the applicant takes this to heart. I also have great concerns about the project as presented, and I think there's a, not to use a pun inappropriately here, but a real uphill battle to get this sort of project approved. So it's with a little bit of reluctance that I've moved to grant the continuance. I do think it's appropriate to give the applicant an opportunity, but there's a lot of work to be done on this project before I think it could ever get through the commission. So that'll make a motion.
Okay, thank you. Other comments or second?
Second. But I think one of the things we need to do is make sure that we're asking staff to bring it back within 75 days. Not let that become out of power. So with that, I will second the motion.
Can we set a date?
We can continue to a date, sir.
Yes, actually, in order to ensure that we do come before this commission in the 75 days, and that the meeting is held downtown to ensure that the community members can attend, we will be returning back on October 10th.
Okay, so give me the date again, Lisa.
Thursday, October 10th.
Okay, so we have a motion. If agreed by both, yeah, we have a date certain.
I'll modify my motion for that. So we need it to be October 10th.
And also, I'll accept that modification.
Dana and Robert, thank you. James, would you call the commission, please?
Certainly. Commissioner Perlman?
Yes.
Commissioner Leff?
Yes.
Commissioner Cardoso?
Yes.
Commissioner Keene?
Yes.
Commissioner Olubumian?
Yes.
Commissioner Roshan?
Yes.
Motion carries.
Thank you very much. And again, thanks for your patience and everybody who is here. I'd like to go back to item 5. Thank you all very much for your patience. This is case number CGC 2012-3028 CUZ Newman Associated CEQA. This is the Council District Number 4, General Plan Manager.